Hello everyone, my name is Raylazor and welcome back to Ring of Fates. In the last one, we took down Old Town, and today we're heading off to Mount Vow. So for preparations, I recommend squishy heroes like our Selkie over here buy some Cure Madrasites. So that's what we're going to be doing today. Stock up on as many as you want because I have a tendency of getting injured quite a bit, so I'll be buying quite a few of these. I also encourage you buy some Ethers or Clear Madrasites as well, because you're gonna probably want to use a few charge attacks. For me though, I have that pretty much under control. I don't think I really need any of the offensive Madrasites, so let's head on out and deal with Mount Vow. Four times. So I think this is gonna be one really, really long video. And I'll try my best to make it short by going through this thing as fast as possible. But same run of the mill, Jill. Is Jill a word? What we're doing is basically clearing out every map. Now this first area into Mount Vow is really big and has two entrances you can go from. So what we'll do is clear out the entire map first, then we'll check out the restricted area, our alternate entrance, and then just run straight towards the next area that we're supposed to go to. You'll notice that that north entrance over yonder is actually blocked off, and that's because that's unlocked during your second run about in Mount Vow. Now I might miss some enemies here and maybe some chests as well. I don't know if I made it clear or not, but I'm not really going for those since they have generic loot in them, excluding permanent upgrades, of course. And, well, it's a really large expanse of areas. A lot of enemies are very well hidden and won't spawn until you're pretty much right up on them, so that's something I'm not too concerned about since 4 runs should be just enough for all the EXP we want. Otherwise, we can do our basic run-of-the-mill jump and hit some bat kind of dealio. And everything else should be just fine. Something that we need to worry about though as Selkies are those ice bombs over there. They have a tendency of freezing you and using other spell casts that can pretty much spell your doom in a single hit. Sometimes two. Either or, being frozen is terrible, being frozen in a crowd is even worse, and being frozen by a bomb is the worst. Something to keep in mind. So there's another one right over there. I definitely want to use my tribal abilities whenever I can, just so I can avoid getting right in front of them like so, because they're very dangerous. And you'll probably hear me freak out if I ever get too close to one, because they're just terrible. They end recording sessions, is what I'm trying to say. I will hop into the start of a recording session, get smashed by one of these ice bombs, and immediately have to start over and re-record. Just like that. Alright, so that's your 38, and he'll usually be able to pull off his second attack. Luckily for us, we don't have to worry about that, and so, because of that, I'm just gonna stay up here and see if I can just shoot some tribal abilities at him. It doesn't seem like our little button is working, so let's readjust. There we go. And that... I don't think this is gonna work out, actually. Maybe we can back up, shoot through the wall, ground. Oh, there we go, we got a hit there. Alright, let's do this instead. There we go, got our level 10, that's pretty good. I do believe we're getting a special upgrade today in terms of level ups as well, I'm not too sure. But something to keep in mind. There's going to be tons of exciting things happening around in Rebena Te Ra and around Mount Vow today. A little bit of trivia here and there. So stay tuned if you're a fan of Ring of Fates, because maybe you did not bear the loneliness of playing multiplay by yourself. This bat is being pretty annoying, so let's just try to match its height. There we go. If you manage to get a good attack on it, I believe you're able to just cancel its spell. Otherwise, these bats aren't too dangerous except in crowds, because they do have a spellcasting ability, but not one we really need to worry too much about. Well, it's freezing, bats are relatively harmless by themselves. So let's just worry about this goblin. For some reason, I didn't get knocked up, so I'm pretty okay with that. Not being hit. Or that upwards attack. I know what I just said sounded very wrong, but it's okay. Let's not go down that road since we're in the cold tundra and I think no one is interested in having their butts be frozen off. Instead, let's focus on these bombs and staying a far, far distance away so we don't get our butts frozen off. You also notice the moose around here have a nice wintry skin, some new furs to keep themselves warm. You'll notice that moose have a pretty much a different skin depending on the climate, which is kind of cute. If only Crystal Chronicles was popular. If it was, I reckon that those moves would be little plushies on the Final Fantasy shop. if a Final Fantasy shop even exists, I don't know. Just a presumption there. Jumping on them and latching onto them are no good, obviously, since you get knocked around pretty quickly. So obviously, just match it. One jump is enough. Sometimes I try double jumping in to get the height advantage. Of course, this rarely works because the bats are able to meet your speed and just be a little bit higher and out of reach. Otherwise, let's climb up over here. We have a few more ice bombs to deal with, like so. I'm really afraid for one of the parts up ahead because I believe there's like 3 or 4 bombs stacked on top of each other. Something like that. They hang out in crowds, apparently, and that is a very scary thought for me. If I get hit by one of those, you'll see why. Hopefully, though, I'll have touched a checkpoint recently before that happens. We're working our way towards the blocked entrance right now, so we can just read that sign that's going to be right there once we get over here. Hey, look, we got over here. Let's read this. No passage due to avalanche. Coupeau. So, there you go. Can't access this area just yet, but something we'll definitely be covering in this video, so fear not. In the meantime, let's keep running around the area and shoot at lovely enemies just chilling out everywhere. Sometimes I wonder if these guys are just infinitely respawning. Definitely not the case, but still. Sometimes you just have to wonder, because there's certainly a surplus of enemies on this map. Alright, 2 to deal with, that's fine. So far, so good. Not too much to worry about, no life-dangering moments just yet. While Mount Val may take quite a bit of time in order to clear out completely, it's actually really fast for Selkies to go through, so I'm not too concerned about our 2 speedruns, just our going through 2 areas. Ugh, I don't know if that line made sense. Anyways, by going through this area, you'll see this was our alternate entrance at the start. I believe that you have a bunch of Moogle plants here in story mode, which is why it's accessible. Otherwise, though, I think that's pretty much it. So let's move on ahead and ignore all the enemies spawning all around us because I don't feel like going through them for a second round. There will be plenty of enemies around here, I can assure you that, so nothing to worry about. Let's move on here and deal with more enemies in another large expansive map. Some of these maps contain a bunch of Moogle plants, so if you're into those things, you can always grab one or two. This little area here is especially important, I believe, in a little bit upcoming. In the meantime, I get to look at how the layers and the groundwork is kind of like glitching out. You can tell that these things are made of little tiles stitched together by that, but I don't know, it's kind of neat. Someone could certainly like play around with that if they were to ever make a game. Stitch tiles for a map, like playing an RPG on a blanket. Now, we have a bunch of chests around here, and when I activate these, a bunch of enemies are gonna spawn out. Just like that. Yes, each chest here is guarded by a bomb, I believe, so let's take a step back, and what you want to do is try to isolate it so it's one at a time. And as a Selkie, fire your arrows like a coward you are, but it's okay, because we're a ranged class, so we don't have to worry too much about that. These guys should not cause too much trouble, since we're in a pretty large, expansive area, where we won't have to worry too much about monsters getting too close up on us. There we go. Now I want to grab that material there, back up, use my clear magicite since that's capped out, and then go back to our basic inch closer fire arrow at them kind of movement, and then we should be pretty good to go. There we are. Now, does that fourth one contain a... No, it doesn't. Okay. Contain an ice bomb, which it does not. Spoiler alert, I'm sorry. I spoiled the last 5 seconds of the video for you. I'm a terrible person. Now we can drop off this cliff face, and I recommend this so you can clear out this area properly and grab all the Moogle plants you would ever want. I believe Moogle plants are generally used for very special items like jewelry or like, I don't know, very cosmetic driven items like weapons, stuff like that. I don't know. I don't really encounter Moogle plants in crafting very much, but it's always a luxury item to have considering the shop sometimes sells them, not always. It's pretty much a good thing to hoard all the materials you can get in Multiplay, and of course sell stuff off that you don't really need like copper shards or iron shards. I haven't cleared out my inventory yet, but once we approach the 99 material slot thing, I would definitely be sure to do that. another escape dodge from an ice bomb, luckily enough. That was almost not so fortunate. There we go. Alright. Now let's grab this Curer Magicide and just chuck it at something so we can use it right away without going through our pocket inventory. There we go. So far, so good. As the saying goes, Raylazor never stops saying, so far so good. Anyways, words like that. I don't know. You get a lot of that dead space by playing this game in multiplayer. Especially going through it 100%, or as close to 100% as you can get, which is like 90%, 80%, maybe if I'm really underachieving 70% or something. I can always go on a random tangent and talk about something, I guess. But otherwise, I don't think we really need to worry about anything here. Cool. Let's come back on up and deal with a few bats and goblins. Are there no bats here? I could have sworn there were bats here. Well, great, we just get a goblin then. I'm just gonna fire arrows at you from long range because I'm not interested in dealing with your rock throwing there, mister. Come on, there we go. All right. Sure. Okay, let's crack this chest open. What do we have in here? Thunder Magicites, okay, we don't really need those, but you can always use more. More the merrier, I suppose. If we're dealing with Old Town Boss, that is. Okay, you are a little too close there, especially with that bat. Let me just do a little bit of long ranging here. Yeah, that's fine. That's good. Okay. Inch closer. Switch to tribal ability if we can. Don't feel free to let them explode because you still get EXP from that. It may feel a little bit weird leaving them to just blow up without any target, but you definitely do get your EXP, so no worries about that. Let's work on this bat here who spawns in just a little bit too late, so we shouldn't have to worry too much about you. There we go. No spell for you, and you're down. Great. I don't really need this, but we'll do it anyway since we already have a cherry cluster here. Another bat. So many. Kind of scary if we encountered all of them at once with their ice ability. They would just stack attack after attack, since we don't seem to get a magic resist in the same way as other enemies do. And Selkies are particularly very low on HP, so something to consider. And especially with this kind of build, we don't have the highest of defenses. Alright. Stay away from you, we got a move there. This is generally just a really annoying area now. Yeah, let's try to get this. Oh, you can hop ledges that high. Great. Well, I'm just gonna readjust real quick. Awesome. Hello. Yep, don't get so close, please. Ah, click as fast as I can. Don't kill me. Oh, okay. We're good. A little bit worried there. Do we have anything over here to play around with? I think we do. I guess we don't, actually. Never mind, I got your hopes up. Maybe somewhere up ahead. Hey, somewhere up ahead. There we go. Alright, we'll be talking about that little area in a second. And if you're really savvy, I think you'll know why. But otherwise, let's just back up. This is not very comfortable, I must say. I'd rather go the cowardice road, if it means I won't die and have to reset my playthrough. Or my let's play, my episode. Yeah, there we go. I don't know, I call them episodes, but then I realized TV shows are called episodes, and those are really high budget, so I feel like I should call them parts, but that doesn't have the same ring to it, so I use those words flip-floppity, as you should, actually. Alright, let's work on this bat. So far, so good. If you didn't know, these bat eyeballs have triangular eyeballs, I believe. I'm pretty sure we've encountered the item description of bat eyeballs already, but that's kind of weird. I think it means that they can't really move them. They always have their eyes open. Maybe they're really sleepy. Sleepiness leads to aggression, which is why these bats are so violent. Conspiracy? No? No? Maybe? Alright, at any rate, let's move on ahead. This little area can be a little bit weird sometimes. Not always. Primarily weird for Yukes, really, when they have to put the platforms around. There's another little platform area that's kind of weird for both Yukes and other classes. But over here, let's clear out this area first, since we seemingly have a moo infestation. I'm curious if you can just use a nice fire spell on them. Okay, by that I meant, you know, all three, but sure, that's fine. Let's just keep casting it. I'm sure this will make it work out. That one decided to teleport somewhere else. I have another. I don't think it's a very effective spell, but it does more damage, but it's a little bit slow on the cast, I will say that. Let's clear out this area here, and then maybe we'll be able to hop to the next little part. Cool. Let's climb up here and grab an item. I don't think you can really access those regularly. Who knows, maybe yooks are actually really good at jumping. But then they'd be Selkie, so that's not the case. What's in the box or the barrel? We're gonna get a piece of iron. That's very effective usage of a barrel. And an iron shard, even better. Great. Anyways, we can hop over here, and if we were a yook, we'd be able to light this candle, moving this platform towards here. And that would allow us to drop off in the back. Instead, we're just gonna have to double jump here and grab this Moogle plant. Now, let's get back to storytelling. Poor Raylazor, doing his test playthrough of this, looking for all the permanent upgrades of each area, could not find one here in Mount Vow. I wonder why. You see, Story Mode has a lovely barrel hanging out over here, which contains a HP boost. Two HP boosts, actually, if memory serves correctly. At any rate, they're apparently not in Multiplay, probably because of that uke ability. Still a little unfair if you ask me, since they left the Moogle plant here, but I will show on screen right now a video of me getting a lovely HP boost in this little area in single player. There we go. Alright, let's move on ahead. A little weird since I had to do a pause there just saying nothing, knowing that I'll have to edit this in post. But that's lovely. Anything else around here? I don't think so. With that, I guess we should move on. Yeah, let's do that. Up on here. Oh, we didn't need to get that high. Okay. I think there is a checkpoint here since we have two entrances. Straight up ahead, so on the bright side, we'll be able to get to a checkpoint in case I get hit by a bomb. I'm halfway tempted to run to the checkpoint right now just to make sure I don't eat bomb for breakfast. But let's avoid that and just try to have a little bit of faith in me, yes? Yes, I should have faith in myself. Alright. Do a little bit of maneuvering. Ooh, okay. So far so good. And we are clear for this little bit. Anything else? This area is very vertically inclined. It's a very vertical map. A little bit annoying this means because bombs and other enemies can drop right off the ledge and murder us. A little bit good for us because Selkies are very good at vertical movement, so I think this will suit us just fine actually. There we go. Now, let's climb up on this platform. Doing great, Selkie. You're going to be just fine. Ah, okay. Bad ride. Alright, let's ride it back up. Okay, or fall off. You know what? I'm having none of this nonsense. Let's just... Okay, well, the platform blocked me anyway, so I couldn't even do that. Not my day. Alright, what do we have here? Money? I'll take money. This is a good payment. Mainly because that's what you usually pay people with. Anything to the left? A barrel? Okay. Who is leaving all these barrels up here anyways? Like, come on. Don't you know how to clean up after yourself? Jeez. Okay, there's also a right side to this area, I believe, so we can just check that place for a little bit. And then we'll move on ahead. I can see there's a Moogle plant down there, so there might be a few more. And with that also means probably a bunch of enemies that I don't really feel like dealing with, but... You know, you gotta do what you gotta do, so let's just drop down real quick. Okay, one Moogle plant, and I think that's pretty much it here. Since there doesn't seem like there's really any more map space for this. You never know, there could be a really high, like, secretive platform containing the secret Mega Moogle plant. which is non-existent in multiplayer, unfortunately. I wonder what the Mega Moogle Plant actually gives you. I always assumed it would give you like 3 Moogle Plants or something. Like you can smash up a little Moogle Plant and it'll turn into 3 Moogle Plants. That's kind of horrid. If we climb up this ladder, we'll be able to see a bunch of chests. And by cracking them all open, hopefully in one go, you get a bunch of Magicites, which you probably don't need. Unfortunately, they didn't arrange these in rainbow colors, which makes me a little upset. You could have a very pretty display right here, but they decide to just mash them all together. Albeit, they probably don't have all the colors to do that. Anyways, let's talk to this Moogle. We don't really need a stamp here, so no, I don't feel like playing Blazing Caravans. Albeit, I do play it on my own time, and I am very frustrated with how difficult it is to get first place for no reward whatsoever. Probably something from the original Final Fantasy games. I don't really know what to mention of. Okay, the sign tells me about nonsense, so we're pretty much one or two maps away from dealing with the boss, which means we are making some pretty good leeway. 20 minutes, not the best, but not the worst. I don't feel like going to town after this, and after our speedrun, so let's just go through Mount Val 4 times before we actually head to Rebena Te Ra. Mainly because there's a ton of townsfolk and stuff, and it would be really awkward dealing with some new NPCs, but not all of them. And as much as you would probably want to just hear the NPC talk and leave, I won't let you. You will have to stay here and watch me play this video forever! No. Forever is not exactly on my schedule, so maybe we can schedule some other time, maybe when I'm dead. Are there Let's Players in the dead beyond? Let's not find out. Not today, at least. Okay, let's move on. Up on this platform, move on up. Lovely, another floor cleared, another bomb to deal with. I'm just gonna, please don't move closer to me. You're very scary looking. It's almost Halloween, so I don't know. Maybe this video will go up in the same week as Halloween or something. That would be cool, wouldn't it? I could say, you know what? Let's just take a little bit of sidetrack here. I know it's like covered in snow here, but let's be frank. It's pretty much covered in snow for Halloween in Canada. Happy Halloweening. Yes, you know what I said. And happy Halloweening to you, chit, specifically. Halloweening. He calls it Halloweening. I don't know what else to tell you, okay? Chit has been shown in one or two of my previous videos. He says strange things. He calls chips like chaps or something. I don't know. We're not exactly the best at English, as you can tell. Alright, let's clear out this bomb. There we go. Deal with the bat. Move on ahead. Bunch of grapes there, that's pretty good. Come on, there we go. 1, 2. Can I grab you? Yeah, let's... Okay, well I can't grab you. You know what, I'm gonna grab you. Can't tell me what to do. Okay, hold on. Okay, well, I just killed it, so it won't even matter. Forget that. Let's just move on. Another bat, okay. Let's just cancel that spell and focus on small little hops and bow and arrow time. So far, so good. And I think this might be all this area has to offer. We have all our pockets filled up, which is kind of amazing. Considering we didn't exactly buy everything. I did buy quite a few Cura and Healing Magicites though, and apparently I didn't really need them this time around, so that's good. That means I'm getting better at playing this area. Let's hop on these platforms and move on. I should mention, by the way, before you clear out this area, be careful. Don't try to run up ahead because there's like bombs and bats and everything terrible spawning underneath it. A really weird area, all in all. Anyways, let's move on up ahead, and I believe we're going to be dealing with Al's uncle. Well, ancestral uncle at any rate. Generally, this bird isn't too hard to deal with. You can just do your standard run, jump, arrow. But you can also be a power player. And after you do your silly dive thing, or dash, you're a bird. Those two things don't really work out. You can actually just immediately attempt to double jump on top of the bird and start smashing its skull open. So Something to keep in mind, it has an annoying tendency of just using a bunch of special attacks, which makes it a lot harder to jump on it, especially when you're facing the wrong side of the camera. Come on, bird, start dive bombing. I don't really care about your little slidey glide. I'm here to hop on you. There you go. Oh god, that's not what I meant. Oh, by the way, did I mention this bird hurts? Generally pretty easy since you're able to kill it very quickly, but getting hit by this thing is not exactly the best thing to ever happen to me. There we go, we're on it now. And generally this makes it pretty easy to take care of this bird. You really get knocked off, and when it does that flippy flip, sometimes you're able to double jump and land directly on its head once more, which means you can pretty much stay on its head forever. If it's floating on low distances, you can double jump right on immediately. And I'm playing this very dangerous right now, considering my health bar is halfway through. Yet here I am, still on this bird's head. Let's just get away so I don't accidentally get a game over too quickly after being so cocky with this thing. Alright, let's just angle. There you go, right on the crystal. Give it a good old stomp. 1-2, 1-2. So far, so good. This bird is pretty much near death. Let's just fall off, because I don't really have any edge awareness, apparently. Don't take me on Mountain Rise. I'm just gonna fall off and die. That's no fun for any of us. You have to do police papers, and I have to deal with being in the afterlife. Something to keep in mind. Now, I want to lure this bird more towards the center of the arena, just so its loot doesn't fall off into God knows where, and then we can kill you and take all your goodies. Yes, what do you have? Dark Crystal, Garnet? Ugh. Well, on the bright side, it has completed silk and leather, so we don't have to craft too much of that. And that's pretty much it. Not bad. Alright, well, that's pretty much it for our first run through of Mount Val. Only took us 26 minutes. Let's speedrun it. Let's go. Okay. I should use a different word than speedrun, because I'm probably just hurting the feelings of all the speedrunners out there, but, you know, I don't have any better words. I'm pretty sure I already said this in a previous video, but it's okay. Mind you how easy and how fast it is when you don't have to deal with every single monster in the area. I highly encourage if you are playing as Selkie to just completely ignore the whole kill all the monsters in an area to get the EXP thing. There's better places to grind and you don't have to worry about clearing every single area to keep it in mind. I just don't want to grind in my playthrough of Multiplay, which is why I need to make sure I have the adequate amount of EXP before getting to each area. Now, where am I supposed to go here? I just forgot. Oh, right. Okay, let's just hop on this. Right. Okay, I missed. I might just never going to be able to make this jump, because I have a feeling that's going to be the case. Whatever. This goblin's taking a ride with me. Let's go, buddy. Goodbye, buddy. Right, he wasn't too enthusiastic about this, mainly because he was my enemy. But nonetheless, the whole vertical thing about Mount Val is working in our favor, since we're able to move through this area fairly quickly. And I think we're nearly at the doorstep of the bird monster. Hey, look, we're at the doorstep of the bird monster. Let's go. Bring it on. I'm not afraid. If only you flew a little bit lower so I could actually deal with you. But no, all you want to do is glide. Glide, 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 glide. That's all your birds ever think of. Come on, think about something cool like pooping on someone's head. You're a huge bird. It would be amazing. It would be awesome. What do you even eat? Moogle plants? That must not be a very good diet. Have you tried meat? Meat is pretty good. We'll be dealing with a little bit of meat in this video. Aside from the fact that this video is going to be really long. Another kind of meat. Come on, stop gliding. We're gonna get nowhere like this. All right, I'm gonna stand here and make myself a nice big red target. At the very least, we got the red part down. There we go. Yeah. Oh, okay. You missed clearly, because that was a few meters right behind me. But that's fine. At least I'll be able to hit you now. Oh, did I get the jump in time? No, I did not. Oh well. Okay, let's heal up. Since we're in the danger zone with our health bar. Cool. This bird does not have its accuracy very well calibrated. You alright there? Am I giving you a headache? Is that it? Okay. Let's land straight on the bird. There we go. Back at it. So far, so good. Nothing to worry about. I still want to lure the bird near the center despite me trying to go through this quickly, because the loot is always lovely. And it means I'll be able to show off more costumes and miss less items. I know for a fact that something called the Hero Mask has been dropped already in the Valley of Heroes as well as Old Town. But we haven't encountered it in this playthrough yet, so I don't plan on showing it until we do. And if we never do, then tough luck, buddy. You're gonna have to look for it somewhere else. It's basically a mask, by the way. Come on. Hey, you don't chuck magicites at me. I already have all the magicites I want. You get down there, buddy. Yeah, that's right. I'll have you for Thanksgiving. Too bad Thanksgiving has already passed. This dates this video very much. Anyways, let's grab these items. Get a nice surplus of silk and leather and maybe a little bit of iron so we don't have to worry about that. And hop on into Mount Vow for the third time because we are going to go on to the next area now of Mount Vow. Now, remember how I said there was a sign there which we couldn't access because it said avalanche? As you can see, it's cleared over now so we can move right on ahead. Now, this area does actually have permanent upgrades, so lucky us, the second run through will yield us some profit. A lot more than you'll expect because there's actually two sets of permanent upgrades here. I'm not sure if that's the same case in story mode, but regardless, it does mean that we can get all the items we'll want. Not bad. Okay, let's take a look around here. Ice cubes, which you can jump on and move and carry and pretty much use because they're cubes. Stuff we don't really need to worry about because we're Selkies and we are superior in our jumping ability. Yes. Alright, so this area splits into two, which is a little bit annoying, but what we'll do is climb up the left side and hop on over to the right side. Nothing we really need in that, so let's move on. Doing great so far. Alright. If only I was really good at this game and if I knew how to, like, break code, I would be so interested in, like, just searching through this game's item files and whatnot. This is one of those games that I played the crap out of, just trying to, like, get every tiny little bit of secret. Obviously, I still missed quite a few things, but it's still an exciting thing to find stuff in a game that you do enjoy quite a bit. Alright, let's hop off to the right side of this. Any chests? Anything cool, maybe? Well, this entire area is cool, but I guess we're not really talking about that, huh? Okay, frozen, chalked. Not too much to worry about. Lightning bombs aren't too much of a threat to us, actually. It's a little annoying that they're able to stun you and make it so you can't use any items, but still generally harmless. It's just getting a little cute little zap, alright? Not too much to worry about. Don't freak out about it. I don't think a zap like this would work anyways, unless it was like a thunder shock, I suppose. Come on. I want to kill you before you blow up because this is a very bad place for you to blow up, I assure you. Okay, there's a chest over there which I want to get at. I forgot about that drop. Let's climb back up. There we go. One, two. Break it open. I think there's a scroll in here. There we go. What's in the scroll? We get an iron helmet scroll for our endeavors. That's nice. I'm not sure how long I want to keep the red clothes because eventually the defense is a lot more important than a little bit of offense. I'll probably switch it off this video actually, just so we have some variety in costume. I am obviously a fashionista, so don't you worry about it. Alright, let's clear the enemies up here first, since we're going to be climbing up here a second time afterwards, so we might as well roll out the red carpet while we still can, with the enemy's blood. There we go. Bunch of spiky turtles hanging out around here. Cool. Anything else? No? Awesome. Let's move back on down here. As you can tell, with the scrape marks, we need to push this platform into the spot necessary. Except when you're a Selkie. Then you don't really need to do that. I'll show that in our fourth run through, so no worries. But for now, we'll push it in as we should. Now, let's talk about story. When I was playing through the story mode of this area, I actually forgot about how to pull and push. I didn't exactly know how that worked, and despite that there were scrape marks there, I didn't realize that I could just run into it and start pushing the platform. So instead, I ran around trying to clear out every single monster in the area. I dropped magicites down, flipped about, going nuts, and I never knew how to move this platform into place. Obviously, when you're in story mode as well, you're playing as a Clavat, so you're unable to double jump up ahead, so that took me a good hour or two in order to figure out that you could just push the platform. Okay, now, there's a spot up here for a chest, which I don't know how we're going to get at just yet, but there's also a bunch of snow platforms here, which we want to hop on over to, and this will yield us our first permanent upgrade. Two SP boosts, which will yield us two permanent points of SP respectively, I believe. Unless it's four, I don't know what to tell ya. There we go. And let's move on around here. Jump on this. There we go. As you can see, it would sink down, and no amount of fast jumping would be able to help you out there. Okay, so we have two bats being a little annoying, so let's just do short jumps where we can. Simply because they'll just match our height. So let's wait for one to sink down. There you go. And their general normal attacks aren't too worrisome either. It's really just there to be an annoying stun, I guess. There we are. Now, how are you gonna get at that chest? Just like that, I suppose. And with that, we'll be able to get ourselves a not code outfit, something we don't need to worry about, but something you can take a look at in the previous video if you're interested. It's near the end, by the way. Ooh, I got stunned there. Okay, a little unlucky, but nothing to worry about. Let's just move around in circles until we aren't stunned. And I think I made a really bad mistake by jumping straight into the center of these guys, since they're clearly not very enthusiastic about this. Just spin around in circles here, work on this a little bit here and there. Oh, I got shocked again. Alright, you know what? I'm gonna abort this real quick. Let's use our potions, because we have a bunch of potions on the ground, so it's always good to just restock. There we go. And it looks like they feel like clumping together. Not too good. Right, let's use a charge attack on you. There we go. And I believe charge attacks are able to bypass blocks, which is a great thing if you're having some trouble dealing with a very annoying enemy. It looks like we're going to get a level up, and unfortunately, it seems like we're not going to be able to get that special ability I mentioned. That's going to be in the next video then. Guaranteed, I promise you. By killing all the enemies, we'll be able to unlock a bunch of ice platforms to hop on up. Guess what? You can bypass those too as a Selkie, so you don't have to worry about a bunch of annoying bombs and a goblin. So let's keep on moving ahead. We're doing great. Dog's gonna do a weird shake. That's fine. Now, let's move over to the right side first, and over here we should be able to see a ladder. Now, we have to pretty much clear our way back up to the top, kind of like Old Town, in order to get at a permanent upgrade. Something that you can easily miss when you realize how close a nice save point is, a nice checkpoint. But something nonetheless that rewards you quite well, because health is a very annoying thing to max out considering you only get 2 points per item. Anyways, let's climb up here. And we're doing great so far. Moves aren't a danger at all, just your basic enemy. Reskin to show how cute they are. Apparently I knocked an item out of it, that's pretty impressive. Not too much of a thief though, so I'm not too interested. Actually, I'm very interested now. What can I do with this? Can I just keep doing this forever? No, I can't. Garnet! Alright, give me some more things, buddy. Okay, I didn't really want those potions, but alright, buddy. You save those for whoever you can, which is no one, because you're dead, and you're gonna get buried in snow and frozen, and probably, like, I don't know, something terrible. Alright, let's hop on ahead, and this will yield us 2 HP boosts, which will give us 4 permanent points of health. And another spiky turtle. Or 2, apparently. No, that's a bomb. Okay. Let's just worry about you for now. You're a little bit annoying in the amount of damage you're able to do. I don't know how you got over here, but you just made this a little bit more dangerous for me. So, just stay over there, please. Yeah, just... I think we should see other people. Wall. Oh, no! I wanted those materials. Okay, we're coming. Can I pull this? Yeah, let's... Will this shake the items off? I don't think it will. Yeah, I doubt it did. Let's hop back up. Because I want them. What do we get? A piece of copper and garnet. I wasted your time for a piece of copper and a garnet. Totally worth it. Let's go on straight through into our lovely checkpoint area and push our platform over to the right. Or this wall, rather. I guess this is to shoot the winds. I don't really care. There's a Moogle hangout in this corner where we'll be able to get a stamp, apparently. There we go. And now we can touch our lovely checkpoint rock. We can move our ice bits around, but we can also just double jump up here, which I'll do since, well, you can see the ice box right there. It doesn't really matter. Now, let's head on over and fight. Al himself. Now, this is probably the most annoying boss fight for pretty much every class. He's so far up in range, it's very hard to hit him with melee attacks, and as you can see, a Selkie needs to do this all day. Not to mention, the magic needle he pulls out is quite a bit annoying, which I want him to show off before we showcase some of the special tactics we can do with the Al. I think this is actually Am I really too far out of range? But one of them is, if you're too far out of range at a very early state, Al won't be able to target you. So let's move up and have you just cast that spell. Our second way of beating Al is to double jump on top of his crystal and hug straight top. This will make you invulnerable to his fire attack and pretty much every other attack except for a spell which casts a meteor on you, I guess, a rock. So as you can see, this makes this battle a lot easier. Now, if you're a little bit worried about getting too close to Al and you're afraid that the fire thing will screw you over, just feel free to do the long range tactic. That thing doesn't always work as well, so that's something to keep in mind. But these are very easy tactics compared to trying to deal with Al on your first time through as a Selkie, because I can promise you, this is very annoying. This fight is very melee oriented, and even so, that's very annoying. Nonetheless, we take out Al, and we're able to get all his lovely treasures. Break him out of the crystal, he disappeared as well. But I off to go do some hot springs things with Yuri and Latov, but hey. I don't know how to access that thing. You guys ditched me, I wish I could go have nice hot springs, but no. Anyways, we've cleared out the area, nothing else around here, the battlefield is clean, and we're off to do our fourth run. Let's go! I believe it's even faster now because the second time around is even more vertically based, so very good news for us, Selkie. A very profitable four runs for us today. And then we'll be able to head to Rebena Te Ra, where we'll be able to feel the warmth of people's souls and our toes. Okay, so far so good. As you can see, bypassing all this ice makes it a lot easier. Who said Selkies were bad with snow? We're great with mountain climbing. We can move straight on ahead from here and just double jump up this. And I believe right up here too. There we go. Let's ignore these stupid bats. Come on, leave me alone. Don't you have something better to do, like get eye surgery? Let's move up here and ignore the goblins and bombs that apparently didn't want to spawn and double jump up here as well, I guess. Sure. As you can see, a very fast way to get through and to the boss, so this is one of the places you can go for if you're looking to grind for some boss items. Especially since the boss can't even touch you. Great day, huh? You don't even have to push the wall because you can double jump off that. And you can land on the ladder as well, off the crystal, but apparently I'm gonna fail that. And I can't get my initial jump because it keeps switching over to my double jump. Come on, let me get on this ladder. Oh, jeez, the thing wants to screw me over the second time because I had it too easy. Well, that's fine because I'm gonna have it even more easy. You can't stop me. Never mind, no I'm not. Leave me alone, fireball. This is a really rough speed through, I guess. Nah, it's fine. Oh, I got hit by a rock. This is where it might get a little bit dangerous because he can cast this repeatedly and then freeze you and then do this and this and all these terrible things to you. Something to keep in mind. Ow, okay, well. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, gosh, let me up, let me up. Oh, okay, I thought I almost lost that right there. A series of unfortunate events, but I guess this just proves to you how annoying and difficult Al is if you don't know how to hop on crystals or stay far, far away from him. Stuff that you can't do as a melee character, so rough times for the other races, I suppose. I would say the hardest class that has to... let me rephrase that real quick there. I think the class that has the hardest with Al would probably be the Lotis. They're kind of short and stubby. And they attack pretty slowly. They're primarily focused on critical hits, which I don't know if they even affect Al, so they might have a rough time since they don't even have a tribal ability to rely on. Yooks have it easy since they have a ranged attack, and if they get close up, they can have both a melee and a ranged attack together. I believe they're also a little bit more magical resistant in general. Clavats, they hit fast. And Selkies, we get to exploit Al in two different ways. But with that, we're pretty much done right here. So let's head on back to Rebena Te Ra. Yeah. Okay, well, I have quite a list of NPCs that I need to talk to, so I apologize if I stop talking for a little bit. Because even the greeter has new lines. Welcome to Rebena Te Ra. People are gradually returning to town. The importance of my work is growing by leaps and bounds. Welcome to Rebena Te Ra, blah blah blah. Haha, okay. Now, here's another special thing. You see, Multiplay is really good when you're a Selkie. It's like Multiplay just knows you because you can talk to animals as a Selkie. As you could tell, Nash only replied to the animals and we couldn't really understand them. In Multiplay, that's not the case. Got so many stinking monsters around ya, can't play or nothing. There you go. Thanks, Tog. Thanks for that crucial piece of dialogue that's very important to everyone. Don't worry, Yooks get a little bit of crucial dialogue as well. But they get to exchange that for nothing, unfortunately. Now let's move on ahead, and we'll be able to deal with these two. No, I think these two say the same thing. Yes, they do. Okay. Up here we have a Neo Selkie boy, I believe, that we can chat with. I'm not sure. Do Selkie boys wear skirts? I have no idea. No way! These aren't eggs, they're rocks! And I was all pumped up about chowing down tonight. Birds. Hmm? Oh, my bad. Hey, you an adventurer? Do you exterminate monsters and stuff? I'm into that kind of thing too. I went over to Mount Vow to thump a few monsters earlier, right? And I came across this freaking big bird's nest. I don't see any mama bird around, so I swiped the eggs. Come to find out later, the whole batch was just a bunch of rocks. Man, I was bumming. I'm thinking these eggs are heavy, but that means they're good. So I haul them back and bam, rocks. So this person had a very rocky journey, ha ha ha. All right, we can also talk to this guard who has new dialogue. I wonder who's really responsible. Who is exterminating monsters? We got people everywhere now, wandering all over the place. I can't even goof off anymore. I'm a big supporter of maintaining peace in the community. It's my job. But what about my peace? Old Town is up ahead. Monsters appear without warning, so please proceed with the utmost caution. I take my job duties seriously. Guarding people's safety gives me a sense of purpose in life. Ugh, I'm bushed. If only I had the ability to sleep standing up. And that's pretty much it in this guard's daily life. Sorry, pal. Just gotta do my job. Now we can go over here and we get to talk to quite the interesting fellow. What is it about the of this town of ours? It pulls people with no sense of style in like a magnet. It's high time I let loose the fury of this golden arm of mine and address this sad situation. I'll start with the worst looking of the bunch. Now let me see. Crikey! Look what you've done to your hair! What color is that? You may even be beyond my help. Still, I think it's worth a try. Let me, the charismatic Kofir, elevate you to Chic Elite. I don't actually know how to say that. Chick? Cheek? Cheek! Chic Elite. There we go. Now, don't talk to this guy unless you're interested in changing your hair color. Since we're playing as a character that can change their hair color, wink wink, all classes except Yuke's, let's change your hair color and see what we get. Mm-hmm, I've got just a look for you. Uh-huh, yes. Oh, blonde? I'm a fan of blonde. Maybe I'll just keep it as this now. Wow, I have outdone myself. Now, if you're ever interested in changing your hair, bad news. Tired of your new do already? Well, you can't be dying it with every change of clothes. It's not good for your hair. You wait a bit. Basically, you need to complete a unique quest every time if you're interested in changing your hair color. So something that you haven't completed before in order to change your hair color. Now, you might be asking, Yukes don't have hair, what do we get? If I remember to, I'll leave a little message on screen which shows you what you get for dialogue when you're talking to this fellow right here as a Yuke. Just a minor change in dialogue, but something that I'm willing to share for you for a price. Changing your hair. But regardless, let's move on. Now we can talk to this fellow right here. Was the clerk at the workshop always that way? Or did she suddenly just, you know? Oh, I didn't mean, no, I shouldn't be judgmental. I'm sure she has her reasons. We'll go over to that sector of the area later. Let's just talk to this guard over here. Let's try to purposely avoid that area for just a little bit.
What? Huh? Unbelievable. Why didn't I see it before? Townspeople are back. I make rounds every day and I'm only realizing this now? I should pay more attention. Not everybody's back yet. No need to leap to rash conclusions. Come to think about it, I did hear the number of monsters that's dropping. Who knows? There could be some nutcase adventurer wiping them out for just kicks and giggles while recording it for a bunch of people, strangers on the internet, whatever an internet is. Alright, let's move on. Now, eventually we're gonna have to bump into this feller, but I'm gonna try my best not to just yet. So let's move on over here and see if we can get a permanent upgrade. You don't say anything new, but the Mugo here now is, I don't know what his name is. He has a very unique name and he is sprawled across the Crystal Chronicles series, so if you've seen this fellow before, he's probably stolen something from you or something like that. Anyways, oh, a customer. How good of you to come from the ends of our expansive community. Profits do suffer while I'm away. I can't leave my business, my baby, in the inept hands of amateurs. Money greases the corporate cogs. It's meant to be spent, so use it. Welcome to the magnificent Mogmart. There we go. Now, unfortunately, for clearing out four areas, we only get one area's worth of upgrades because it resets every area completion, so you can't actually stack upgrades, unfortunately, which is why our workshop and stuff is always empty after each time. Really sad. Business has been better than I expected, but I don't want you to think that's why I came back. We look forward to serving you for many years to come. And to be fair, they have. I've played Crystal Chronicles, Ring of Fates for so long, so many times, so many playthroughs. Anyways, I guess we already know who our guest of honor is, so let's go meet him. Chappie! Yay! I have no idea what I want to, like, give you, what voice to give you, because I don't remember. I'll come up with something absurd, but in the meantime, let's go talk to you. Welcome to Magic Goods. We have magicites for magic and items for your healing needs. Plenty of enthusiasm. That's the way to go. Feels good to be alive. There's no getting away from it. A man who can't earn a living one way needs to try something else. Because believe me, I know, love without money is a flat out lie. No money, no honey. Today we focus on business all the way. Buy as much as you can, as much as you like, that is. So we're gonna just take a quick detour here and sell some items because we don't need that many of these things. Let's try to leave like 7 of each or something. I can't really math right now, so I'm just gonna do this. Well, I'm clearly way off 7 there, but regardless. You know what? Let's just round everything down to a 4, just so I can save myself some embarrassment. Until I embarrass myself some more by rounding things off incorrectly again. You know what? We'll just keep this at 10 though, since we could always use these. Raise magicites. We don't really need to do any magicite stacking since we're a Selkie. And let's just, we'll keep 10 here because we need to use 2 each time. We have 10 cure magicites, so let's just get this down to like a 5. There we go. And since we have a bunch of ethers, let's just get that down to a 3. There we go. Do come again. Yep, I will. And let's talk to the weapon shop person. Oh, hey, a person. I heard townsfolk are trickling back in, so I figured it might be time for me to return too. My favorite thing in the whole world is looking at the smiling faces of my customers while they're bashing in the enemy's skulls. I don't know who to thank, I just know I'm grateful. Forgive me for going on and on about nothing much at all, like those stupid monster lives. Welcome to the armory, where we have almost all the equipment you need to kill monsters who don't even want to fight you. Okay, let's see what we have around here. Anything in terms of equipment? Blue hat, red hat, nothing new here. What's an iron hat? Do I get one of these? Maybe I'll get an iron hat. Body armor, what do we have here? Blue clothes? Yeah, we'll probably go for iron armor. I just remember what it looks like, so we might as well have a nice little decor change. We appreciate your patronage. Okay, well it's finally time for our guest of honor. I don't really know what to give you a voice yet, so I'm just gonna go with something that will ruin your ears. I recommend you turn down the game's audio or the video's audio right now because I think you all know what this voice is going to be.
Greetings! Here, have a smile for free. Step up. Closer. I recently returned to town after a long journey of self-discovery. Oh, how I've missed the hustle and bustle of city life. I look forward to serving you. Is there something on my face? Or perhaps I remind you of someone you know. I do get that a lot. I have the kind of indistinct, ordinary face people often see. But never mind that. What can I do for you today? Welcome to the workshop! We are eager to make equipment to your exact specifications.
Oh, okay, I almost ran out of audio right there, so that was great. Let's see, ran out of air. Silly me. Alright, let's see what we can build here. We can make a steel weapon. I think that's something we should definitely go for, and definitely go for an attack type. Actually, I should probably make my armor first before making more copies of the steel weapon. Hopefully this killer bow is an attack boost, and it is! Lucky me, I get to break the 3-digit attack number. Lovely. Let's move on ahead. We can make an iron helmet. So let's do that. Iron helmet. Can we get a nice upgrade? Oh, that's no good. Alright, well, we'll equip it for now. Ooh, yeah, long locks. Okay, and then let's go look for that iron armor. There we go, iron harness. What do we get here? Ooh, and we get a star, so we get a defense boost. Something I'll definitely want. We're gonna be losing some attacks, so we might as well get as much defense out of that as we can. So where's that iron helmet thing again? There we are. Come on, give me a star. What are we getting? We're getting attack boost. We can get that? Oh, well, alright, I'll take it. Our attack goes back on up, but now I'm curious if we can get attack boost on iron armor. Let's find out. You know what? Let's find out. I'm a curious Joe. We are going to be able to get attack boost. Lovely. So it looks like we get to keep our attack power and some of our defense. Not bad. Well, that's pretty much all I wanted, actually. So let's go into our lovely workshop store and see what we can buy. So I will look around for something we may want. Moonfur, we'll get like 2 of these, round it over to a 10. Actually, we'll get 2 more. Since you need 2 each time you make something, we might as well have a nice even number. And for scrolls, I don't think we really need to worry too much about that either. Now, it seems like we don't have to worry about that, so let's take this opportunity to sell some things. We might as well. What do we have here? Let's just sell some of the basic items, like this Novus weapon, for example. We don't really need tree branches either, though, but I'll probably keep that since it's a nice raw material. We're up to iron weapons. Oh, they're steel weapons. Wait, what? Whatever.
Profits are not our primary goal. Pleasing our revered clients is what means most to us.
Right. Is a killer bow like... Is this... Hold on. I'm sorry, I have no idea if I made a steel weapon or not. Hold on.
Welcome to Chappie's Workshop, where our motto is relax and leave the customizing to us.
Right. Steel weapon? Steel weapon? I've definitely made this before, right? Right? Okay, yeah. Sorry, I'm just... I had a little brain fart there. Okay, let's go back to selling things. Real quick, because this video is clearly not long enough. Iron weapons, we can finally sell these now. Cool. Stylish weapons don't apply to us, so we'll definitely sell those. Bronze helmet is no go. We've already seen that on screen anyways. Green headwear, same thing. Iron helmet, well, we just saw it today, and we got our attack one, so that's pretty good. Same thing for red headwear, which we for some reason have 6 scrolls of, and even worse, 8 scrolls of blue headwear. Hand-me-downs for travel clothes, which we've worn in the beginning. Bronze light armor, which was our first different custom set, I believe. Rugged clothes for green clothes, which we don't really need to worry about. Iron harness for something we just got. We have the not hot outfit, which we've done before, and the not cold outfit, which we've also done before. We're moving on to soft cloth and sturdy leather and smooth cloth, which is something we'll keep in mind. Refined copper is something we don't need to worry about, and with that we'll also sell our iron and copper shards in the future. So let's do that. Welcome to the future, where we sell our iron and copper shards. So I don't want to clear out too many things, because a lot of these materials are useful in one way or another. So we'll just sell the bare minimum, like these shards, which take up a space that we don't really want being taken up. We'll also sell these tree branches, because this is pretty much outdated now. Land goop, behemoth claws, we have an pitite amethyst right here, which will let us get some special abilities on our weapons in the future, as well as equipment, but we don't really want to touch that just yet. And everything else here seems pretty much well in order, so let's leave it at that. Now, let me show you our item screens. So, we have 4 of 99 slots here. So far, so good. And our material thing, which is at 33 out of 99. This is where it gets dangerous. If we hit 99, we can't grab any more items, obviously. So, I need to keep this number low. something that we'll need to keep in mind throughout our playthrough. But in the meantime, let's go show off our lovely iron armor, which frankly seems like it has less defense, but take a look. Oh yeah, that purple ribbon. I don't think it really does anything, but sure. On the bright side, you don't have to worry about your titties getting destroyed, or that one very specific side of your head. Listen, you can tell this is designed to be fashionable, but you know what? I like it. I don't care. Let's not even get into that topic of sexualizing women in games and all that shenanigans. I'm here. I like cute costumes. Let's go do a quest. But first we get to troll King Koka, obviously. Do you guys always have the same party members? Guys? Excuse me? One, Selkie is an independent woman who don't need no man. And two, does it look like she has a man with her right now? It's goddamn right. She's a lone wolf. Except she's not a wolf, she's a Selkie. No shit. If you have at least one higher level veteran among you, you can go to areas with tougher monsters. Your level increases much faster in those areas, so you may want to invite an experienced ally. You'll want to cultivate friends with special skills, form parties that cover a range of abilities, basically have some class diversification, or just have four clubats run straight at an enemy and mash their face in. Over here, the quests available to you are determined by the level of your lowest ranking teammate. Allies who have stayed together a while will be nearly the equal level and can do more challenging quests. Your experience working together may also be an advantage as you coordinate your battle strategy. Bonds are formed in triumph and tragedy. In triumph and in tragedy, pave their own pathways. Was that even a sentence? I have no idea. Let's talk to the advisor. Mind your manners. You are in the presence of His Majesty. Oh, I was wondering who you were. You look like you've been keeping yourself very busy. The townsfolk are coming back in droves. I certainly hope you'll stick around and help us rebuild. Among the quests, you'll find some similar ones. However, in many, you'll face much stronger enemies. I recommend you work your way up, taking on quests suited to your level, then tackling harder ones. Alright, now let's talk to the main man himself, King Koka. Hello. Yeah, splendid, splendid. The town is getting quite lively. I can hear people's voices all the way in here. My strategy to revitalize the realm has been a great success. While a spirit of celebration is in the air, why not direct your energies into tackling a quest? Oh, you poor thing. You're so wrong, but I don't have the heart to tell you. But I do have the heart to ruin your day. You're no fun. Alright. See, you want to do a quest? How about it, huh? Alright, let's go do Area 51. Unearthly rays of light are abducting cows. Jump up and grab the cow's feet to bring it back to the ground. You must keep 3 cows to win. Stage 1, cooperative.
Steak!
Sometimes I get a little distracted, as you know. You see, on the outskirts of town, we have a royal cattle ranch. Ah, the smell of sizzling sirloin. But some rustlers have been stealing cattle nearly every night lately. If this keeps up, what will be left for me to have for dinner? I can't possibly subsist on vegetables alone. I need beef! Sorry, I just get irritable when I don't have enough meat in my diet. You do understand the gravity of my predicament. I need you to see what's going on over at the ranch. They have absolutely best cuts, but I digress. If you see cattle heading off, you grab onto them. I beg of you to make my life the meat eater's dream it once was. I'm counting on you. Probably the most serious quest we've ever gotten from King Koka, so let's get on it. Basically, we have to deal with cows wearing bandanas for some reason. They're kind of cute. They're really fat, adorable cows. Not like scrawny, like evil-looking ones. A while back, I moseyed right on over to the Calgary Stampede over in Alberta, Canada. And over there, we managed to see a bunch of live animals there, including cows. Do you have any idea how large they are? How slobbery they are? I know a farm boy is probably laughing at me right now for how these city folks are acting like. But seriously, that thing was large, and it looked angry, and it looked like it was about to stomp right into me and bite my face off or something. It was terrifying. I don't believe they have teeth, though. Actually, they probably have teeth, but... Definitely not sticking my hand in that pen because... Oh, that thing just looked upset. It looked like some kid spilled chocolate milk on it and it was just about ready to turn that kid into a steak. Eh. I'm pretty sure they're herbivores, but... Listen, I'm not gonna trust it around a really mean-looking cow that had to deal with people all day. It's the same thing where you don't really want to mess with tech support because they're pretty much done by the end of the day. Do whatever it takes to, like, just murder you at that point. Steal your computer, something terrible. IT people would never do that. They might. If that IT person is someone who calls up your phone saying, "Hello, this is Microsoft tech support. We have identified a virus on your computer." A great thing to do with that is to troll them and just pretty much list off the instructions from a Mac. Great way to go. That's it. Quest completed in a minute 30. The new quest, Area 151, is now available. Something to keep in mind, folks. But that pretty much wraps it up. Come claim your prizes. Go! Give me some materials, baby. Where are these things heading? Okay, not very many. We're gonna get 2 throws, I believe, this time. No? No? I guess not. Whatever, I got a tree branch. Stop! And good day till we meet again. Alright, let's head on out and go to our permanent upgrades thing, but then we're pretty much done. Something I'll do off screen, which I really don't want to show, but I promise I won't do anything weird, is that I plan on selling the materials we got from the quest that we don't really need. I'm gonna do a little bit of quick research to make sure I sell everything that isn't important in the future, just so I have enough space. And the reason why I'm so worried about this is because we're running through the same area 2 to 4 times sometimes, and this makes it dangerous because we accumulate a lot of unnecessary items and a lot of items that we generally shouldn't be encountering to begin with, since you're usually supposed to only do one run. So I'll clean that out to make sure we have enough space for future items, but with that, thank you for watching this long 1 minute, wow, what a long video, this 1 hour, 6 minute video, which is gonna go up a little bit more since I'm still talking, of Ring of Fates, where we dealt with a nice snowy Mount Vow. In the next video, we're gonna head on over to Abyss's Forest, and maybe play a game of hide and seek. Who knows? I will see you then.